So your task today is working in a small group. You're going to be researchers. You're going to work together and you're going to investigate some climate change data.
What I really find exciting about these standards is the fact that they put the discovering and encountering of science back in the hands of the students.
By looking at the data, I hope you'll see the importance of this issue.
I feel like there's been a fundamental shift with these standards towards the students being at the centre of constructing their understanding.
Okay, so I'm thinking that it's mostly has a negative correlation since it's going down.
I think by making increasing connections to what we're doing with the world around them, and by getting them to really think about the evidence in front of them, by getting them to engage in scientific argumentation, they're really building real-world skills, and I think they're much more engaged and in touch with what we're doing and see a connection with the world around them and with their lives. So that's really exciting.
Great job, guys. Keep going. That's excellent. Really good.
The next generation science standards are in not only encouraging, but they demand students to think about what they're doing in a much higher level fashion, with much more, using much higher critical thinking skills.
We had a little bit too much rain, and the main part of town flooded.
Well, it becomes real to them because they're looking at what caused all of those events that they were a part of, that they saw, they experienced on a very personal level.
And what is that like when it slumps out? What is that? What kind of real life phenomena was that like, Amelia?
Sort of like a landslide.
We've been observing, we've been writing, we've been analyzing data, we've been making predictions and making claims and supporting with evidence. So, and a lot of those things are critical thinking pieces for every curricular topic.
I think this is actually one of my favorite lessons because it's like hands-on materials.
And if you're the first one to touch it, it's brand new for you.
I want you to take a moment to reflect back through those and see what were the differences. What different things did you see in what did you journal about?
Water just like came out
this time
out
it
that
seems
way.
To have eroded a lot more sand because sand was heavier, so it didn't normally erode that much.
And it like made a little valley if you look at it closely. And then it formed like two little channels.
There's like only sand on the channel.
Why no water came over here?
Yeah, that's exactly what.
Because it's flat. And this side has a slope.
Since I have been more actively engaged in next generation science standards for the last 2 years, I have seen an increase in student engagement and involvement in the work.